next thing on my list is bringing in microorganisms, bringing them into the soil. And that can happen all throughout the year, and really should happen throughout the year. But one of the times that it should happen is when you're planting. And we do this with compost is one way, and compost has advantages, but so do some of these technologies that are coming out in the last 20 years, and especially the last, you know, 5-10 years, are more concentrated products that are very inexpensive, easy to apply. We can bring in sometimes very specific microorganisms that we need, and we can, some of them we apply to the leaves of plants, and you can't do that with compost, and it's so beneficial to get microbes onto the leaves of plants. So I love microbial inoculants, and I have a whole section on them in the academy, but today I just want to show you two of my favorites. And the first one is comes in a bag like this, and it's called mycorrhizal fungi. You may have heard me talk about it before. It's an extremely fine powder, like even finer than the rock dust I showed before. And what it is a bunch of spores of this special kind of fungi, this mycorrhizal fungi that forms a relationship with the roots of most plants in nature and in our gardens. The fungi go out into the soil and bring water and nutrients up to the plant, and then the plant gives food to the fungi in return. So it's this symbiotic relationship that happens. In our gardens, the reason that we're bringing in things like compost and fungi and the next thing I'm going to show you is because they're often lacking, just like the organic matter is often lacking, because of tilling, pollution, chlorine in our water. If we've been withholding organic matter from the landscape by raking out the leaves and taking away grass clippings, certainly pesticides, chemical fertilizers, general pollution and toxicity, monocultures, all kinds of reasons. We don't have the microbial diversity that we used to, or that you would find in an untouched kind of field or forest. So the mycorrhizal fungi would be there in the forest, but they may not be there in our gardens, and so we bring them in very inexpensively. What I'll do here is, for example, parsley, I believe, is quite a big fan of the mycorrhizal fungi. And all I need is that much, like less than a teaspoon. And I don't really even have to worry about getting the whole plant. I just kind of rub and it gets on there, and eventually the fungi will go all over the place, and that'll be great. So that is a really amazing way to help this plant get the nutrients it needs. This fungi, they're going to form a relationship right there. And it's special kind of fungi that do that. And you can buy a pound of this stuff for, maybe around $25-$30, depends on the brand. So that's mycorrhizal fungi. The next one, which you may have heard me talk about before, because it's my absolute favorite, is called effective microorganisms. I get into this big time in the academy. And this is it's a liquid culture of very specific fermenting microorganisms like lactic acid bacteria and Saccharomyces yeast and certain photosynthesizing bacteria in very specific proportions. And so this is made in a lab as a mother culture, and you can actually make your own from that mother culture and activate it like I've done here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to water these plants in with this mixed in quite a lot of water, a few hundred parts water. So I get into this big time in the academy, and this is kind of a good example of the kind of people who would like to go into this academy. As I've said before, it's not really for just kind of average gardeners who want to keep up with the Joneses, is something that I say sometimes. It's really going beyond the Joneses. It's for people who are really passionate about it like I am, and who would be willing and totally interested in learning how to take a culture of microorganisms and mix it with molasses and water and some other stuff and ferment it for a while to make your own, like this incredible inoculant for your garden. So this stuff is just so exciting to me. And it's just for people who are kind of willing to do some of the stuff I've been showing you in these videos, but even in more detail, willing to put in a little work up front to get the benefits of your goals. And my goals are this huge food garden I have all around here, and you know, that's free of pests, that's a really inspiring place to be, and those are just my goals. So EM is a big help in that, and the other microbial inoculants are too. And in the next video, I'll talk a little bit about how I'm gonna maintain this garden I've just planted here, and the EM comes in there as well.